tens of thousands of people has come out to witness the enthronement of Bishop Charles Okunya.
The people thronged the enthronement grounds as early as 8 a.m. As they danced, the residents of Kumi municipality laid banana leaves for the house of bishops and a new bishop to walk on. Bishop Okunya Charles was then consecrated and enthroned by the Archbishop Jonathan Changasha.
Charles is a bishop now. He's no longer a bishop elect.
In his acceptance speech, Bishop Okunya Charles pledged to unite the people of God in Kumi and beyond.
Jesus, you say to your disciples, I leave you with peace, my peace I give you. Consider not our faults, O Lord, but the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you reign and live now and ever shall be.
The enthronement of Bishop Charles Okunya here in Kumi comes after a long struggle and a split from the Church of Uganda.
The controversy depended on the 1st of February 2020, when the Church of Uganda revoked the election of Reverend Charles Okunya as the new Bishop of Kumi Diocese.
Special thanks go to His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Uganda, and Mama Janet Museveni, the Minister of Education and Sports, for accepting to come and grace this occasion. Especially the representative here.
At the Kumi Bomber Grounds today, thousands of people from all walks of life endured the scorching sun to witness Bishop Okunya finally receive the instruments of power to oversee the Upper Nile Diocese under the reformed Anglican Church.
I want to thank the people of Kumi. I want to actually thank the Nile for coming to enthrone for us the Bishop Okunya. It is something that we feel so excited, and we are so glad that this is happening today.
Humble man chosen by God, we expect the best, and we expect God to lead him through his dreams of making the Reformed Anglican Upper Nile Diocese a success, and in Jesus' name it will be so.
The preacher of the day, Reverend Onesmus Mutai Juka, believes the new bishop will bring growth to the house of God.
God,
first and foremost is to obey.
Na solita kere koto arimar.
Stop it.
Rai arimarit.
God can do his work through an obedient spirit.
The people expect the new bishop to lead and forgive those who stood on his way.
All that happened to him, despite the trauma he went through, but I think it was purposed. God had his own plan that today would be the day he would enthrone him into his ministry as a bishop. I am really happy and pray that the Lord will work with him.
The event was graced by bishops from Rwanda, Kenya, South Sudan, and Nigeria. The Son of the Soil and opposition party FDC president Patrick Oboy Amuriat donated 100 plastic chairs and 1 million shillings to the new diocese.
Challenge that I want to put before you, my Lord Bishop, is that you shouldn't betray the confidence that these people have given to you. I am happy that in your church you have said to us all believers listening to you today that you will unite the people, that you are prepared to work with all Christians and Muslim brothers, all the different denominations that profess God Almighty.
The Archbishop of the Reformed Anglican Church, Professor Jonathan Changasha, extended appreciation to His Excellency President Yoweri Museveni for accepting the enthronement of Bishop Okunya Charles to take place as promised.